Come on, Merlin.
Arthur, you know I think that you want to fight against one of the best and strongest knights of England.
Well, I've decided to fight against him, and what a king decides upon, he shall keep.
And most of all, he has to hold himself back when things become dangerous. Well, what do you have to do? You will see very soon whether this is good for you or not. We are entering the territory of the Black Knight. Aren't you afraid of him?
But it would be unlike a king if he forgot his royal duties out of fear. It is my duty now to defeat Mordred.
Right. I have warned you.
Ah, look, Arthur personally. King by Merlin's mercy.
Stop offending me. Draw your sword, or are you a coward?
Coward? Do you believe that I have not enough courage to fight against such a little upstart? Perhaps you give me your sword immediately, then we can save a lot of time and I won't injure you, yeah.
Big mouth.
Oh, then we'll do it as you like. That's what I thought before. Without you, Arthur can't do anything.
Merlin, keep out of this. It's only something between Mordred and me.
He's right. There's an end now to playing the king.
You wouldn't have it any other way.
Merlin, what have you done? If anybody hears that it was not me who defeated the Black Knight, that you killed him with your magic, everybody will laugh at me.
My dear Arthur, first of all, Mordred is not dead, but only unconscious. And secondly, if a certain Merlin did not exist, then nobody could laugh at you because you would be stone dead and England would be without a king again.
Who is that? Merlin, please tell me who that young woman was.
Her name is Guinevere. She is Prince Leo's daughter.
She is the most beautiful woman I have ever seen.
You know, that one can quarrel about good taste.
I'll marry her as soon as I have defeated Mordred, but this time without your help.
Also without a sword. As far as I remember, your sword was damaged in the fighting.
Oh, that's right. But where should I find a new sword in this wilderness?
I see. Now I'm suddenly the right man again. Well, come along with me. And I'll find a new sword for you.
Where are we here? Must be a fairy.
You are right, Arthur. I'm Morgana from Avalon, the country of the fairies of immortality. Why do you come to me?
My sword is broken, and a king without a sword is a bit strange. I would like to ask you for a new sword.
I have known you would come one day. Do you see the sword in the lake? It's the name Excalibur. Go and fetch it.
Oh.
Come on, Arthur. What are you waiting for?
Mercy, King Arthur, spare my life.
I will spare your life, only if you promise not to fight against me again and to accept me as the rightful King of England.
I promise. I invite you to my castle.
Don't trust him. He has submitted to you too easily.
Forget that. Now he knows I'm the stronger one.
Do you really believe that? Don't you notice that you haven't a single scratch?
Why should I? I'm the better and braver of us both.
Nonsense, Arthur. It's the sword. Whoever owns Excalibur and fights with it is invincible. Come here, Arthur. Arthur, I want to show you something.
That's new.
A wedding present.
That's quite nice, but round. We have never had a round table before. Where should I sit as a king if there is no top seat?
But that is the reason why the table is round. All who sit around it should have the same rights. If you believe a knight deserves his merit, then ask him to be seated.
But at the moment, I don't know so many of them.
Don't be in too much of a rush. Select them carefully, and when the time is ripe, then they begin their search for the Holy Grail.
Looking for the wonderful Grail? I don't know anything about it.
That is the Holy Grail, which, if one believes in it, will feed the hungry and heal the ill. Yes, it is a wonder.
Well, Merlin, the idea of the round table is not bad. Knights of the round table. It doesn't sound... Morgana.
Listen to me, Arthur. I have helped you for some time now. Today I would like to ask you something. Take Lancelot into your round table. I have educated him in Avalon, and I promise you he will honor you greatly.
I would like to fulfill any wish of yours. When Lancelot has proven that he is courageous and brave, he shall become a knight of the round table.
Here's someone who wants to test his courage.
I want to prove that I am a true knight of the round table.
You dirty bit, you want to fight against me?
Don't do it, Lancelot. He is too strong. I'm satisfied if you defeat a less dangerous enemy.
The king wants to make a coward of a knight of the round table?
I'm not a coward. I'll teach you a lesson.
Come on, big boy. Don't you carry a sword? We should have a little game.
A game? I want to fight.
Just wait. You take an axe and hit me in the neck as hard as you can. Then I'll hit you back. It's your turn now, Lancelot.
Come on, hit me. I don't want you to show any compassion.
I only wanted to test you, to see how brave you are, yeah.
Lancelot, I think you are brave enough.
Why are you staring at me like that?
You are shining so much. Are you an angel?
I'm not an angel, definitely not. I'm a knight.
A knight? Tell me, what is a knight?
A knight? Well, a knight is somebody who is looking for adventures and who serves his king.
And what is that?
That's a shield.
And that?
That's a sword, my dear boy.
And I also want to be a knight.
If you want to be a knight, you silly boy, then go to Camelot. King Arthur will not hesitate a second to knight you.
Oh.
Camelot.
Oh, who's that coming there?
You should better ask what is coming there.
Oh, look how I drive him away. Come on.
I have a dry throat because of my laughing. Hurry up. Mordred, go get me something to drink.
Mordred, bring me this. Mordred, bring me that. It goes on like that the whole day. I'm not your servant.
But I'm your queen, and you have to do as I tell you.
What a queen. Arthur came to power with the help of Merlin's tricks, and he also got Excalibur from Merlin. Without his sword, he would be the greatest coward of all time.
You dare talk about King Arthur like that. Where is a knight who will take revenge for this offense?
Here. I'm a knight. I want to avenge King Arthur.
You? You are just good enough for a court jester. Be gone.
See, my pretty Guinevere? Only court jesters are ready to fight for Arthur.
I'm not a clown. Start fighting now.
If you want to lose your life, by all means, I don't mind. Okay.
What is going on here?
He was offending you, my lord, so I was fighting him.
And you have won, I see. Only the way in which you did it was not in the manner of a knight.
No, but I have only come here because I want to be a knight.
So you have a few things to learn. What is your name?
Percival.
I like him. He's brave and strong, and it was my fault that first Phil came here. Well, if you want, I'll tell you all that you need to know in order to become a knight.
I agree.
Come here, Arthur. I want to show you something.
What is that?
Stop, Arthur. You may pull as much as you want. You will never do it.
And why not?
Because only somebody who has a good conscience can pull out the sword. Whoever is able to do that will find the Holy Grail. Do you want to try it?
Well, a good conscience. What do you mean by that? That one has never lied in one's life?
That's exactly what I mean.
If I think about it, I must say I don't need a new sword. I have the best sword in England after all. What's about Percival?
Not even white lies?
No, not even white lies.
No, then I better not try it.
Lancelot?
I don't really know. Maybe not.
Nobody? Do you really want to say that there's none among you who has never lied? What about Mordred?
Well, I'll show you. I'm the most honest of your knights. I'll try it.
Come here, Galahad.
Galahad?
Yes, this young man will find the wonderful bowl.
You must prove it first. Come on, Galahad, pull the sword.
Oh.
Everything is ready. You have to go now and find the Holy Grail.
But you have told us. Only Galahad can find the wonderful bowl.
Yes, but he needs your support. Only Arthur must stay here so that England is not without a king.
This is the chance I've been waiting for, when all the knights of Camelot have disappeared. I will succeed in getting the sword Excalibur in my possession.
Galahad, we've almost come to the end of our search. You two will find the Grail together with me.
Well, in our condition, we can't be of great help to you.
We've lost our horses and we can't get on anymore.
Galahad is right. You are the knights of the Holy Grail. One will find it, one will watch it, and one will report it. Go on to this ship.
Lancelot, Percival, don't be afraid.
That sounds quite simple.
My task is done. I shall go to Avalon.
Galahad has found the wonderful bowl. You, Percival, will be the Grail King from now on, as long as you are watching the bowl. Those who believe in it will not be starving, and when they are ill, they will be healed. You, Lancelot, have to go back and tell the world that the Holy Grail has been found. Arthur, the Knights of the Round Table are coming back. I can't believe that.
To hell with them!
Tell me, I want to know everything. Where are Percival and Galahad?
So my task was done now. I withdrew from the life on this earth, but to honor the truth, the task was done. And that was not the only reason. Even a magician can fall in love. And I had fallen in love with Morgana, and I wanted to be together with her and live in a different world.